In this video, I will continue discussing flexibility within DNA structure, focusing on the conformation of the backbone. Study of DNA crystal structures reveals that the epsilon and zeta bonds that join the 3' carbon of the sugar to the phosphorus atom in the backbone adopt two major conformations called B1 and B2. If you compare the two structures, you can see that rotation around these two bonds affects the positions of the nitrogenous bases. A research group looked at the backbone conformations of dinucleotides in a group of crystal structures to see whether a correlation existed between dinucleotide identity and backbone conformation. And this table shows what they found. The N column represents how many of that type of dinucleotide they observed in the dataset. And the %B2 column represents what percentage of each backbone was in the B2 conformation. For example, for the CATG dinucleotide, 52% of the time, the backbone between the C and the A was in the B2 conformation. And the backbone between the T and the G was in the B2 conformation 31% of the time. They took the average of these two numbers to get a flexibility score. A high flexibility score means that the backbones of those dinucleotides did not show a strong preference for either backbone conformation. Those dinucleotides were flexible enough to allow both conformations approximately equally. Conversely, a low flexibility score means that the backbone showed a clear preference for the B1 conformation. In the extreme case, for ATAT, the B2 conformation was never observed, implying that the ATAT dinucleotide is not very flexible at all, at least measured in this way. So this is a way to rank the flexibility of the different possible dinucleotide combinations. Why does this matter? Well, the shape of the major and minor grooves is strongly influenced by the conformation the backbone is in. This figure shows a B1-rich double helix on the left and a B2-rich double helix on the right. You can see that the minor groove is quite narrow in the B1-rich structure, and the shape of the major groove is different. This will affect protein binding. For example, if binding of a protein requires a major groove with a shape like the B2-rich double helix, then certain sequences that can't adopt this conformation will preclude protein binding. But this is just one way to measure the flexibility of the dinucleotides. You could also estimate flexibility by performing molecular dynamics simulations. You can program a computer to model all of the intra and intermolecular interactions for different DNA sequences in water. When you run the simulation, you can observe the range of structures adopted by different dinucleotides. This plot shows just that for all 10 possible dinucleotide combinations. The y-axis is a measure of the entropy of the dinucleotides, with the higher score indicating greater flexibility. For each dinucleotide, they actually simulated the behavior in the presence of different flanking nucleotides to see whether the outer nucleotides influence the flexibility of the inner ones. You can see some similarities between these two sets of data. For example, the AT-AT dinucleotide is not very flexible by either measure, while the CG-CG dinucleotide shows quite a bit of flexibility. But they don't always agree. TATA has intermediate flexibility by the crystal structure method, but seems to be the most flexible according to the molecular dynamics simulations. Neither ranking is definitive. These are just two different ways of trying to answer the same question, and they both have value. So to summarize what I discussed relative to DNA flexibility, I said that flexibility in the double helix is allowed by rotation around 6 backbone bonds, as well as the N-glycosidic bond between the sugar and the base. Remember that Hoogsteen base pairing does occur to a small extent in bDNA. The different rotational and translational parameters such as twist, slide, and roll affect each other and do not vary independently. I illustrated this by explaining how the hydrophobic effect drives formation of propeller twist, which influences slide and roll. And lastly, I showed how different dinucleotides appear to vary in their flexibility, which will influence protein binding to DNA. In the next video, I'll move on to consider structures formed by RNA.